On today's episode, Iran's slow-motion drone attack on Israel. Crazy or genius? Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. When the war between Russia and Ukraine finally ends, historians will note how the technology of air power evolved in a way quite different from that predicted by decades of aerospace engineering. Sophisticated, heavy, stealthy, and fast missiles exist, and they're still in active development. But the real news is the proliferation of swarms of very cheap, very simple, low and slow drones carrying modest explosive payloads. The new philosophy is to overwhelm an air defense with sheer numbers and present individual targets to that air defense, which are individually so inconsequential that they're not worth expending an expensive anti-aircraft missile to bring down. Now, the latest proponent of this theory is Iran, with their recent mass drone attack on Israel launched directly from Iranian soil. Now, this isn't surprising since Iran has mass production capability for low-cost drones and is selling them in quantity to Russia. The Ukrainians have demonstrated that this kind of technology can accurately hit targets 700 or 800 miles away, so it's no surprise that the Iranians, with more sophisticated technology than the improvised Ukrainian drones, could match that performance or exceed it. But there are differences. Russia is a vast territory, and it's impossible to provide adequate air defense for every strategic target over that giant landmass. And individual drones flying low and slow can evade even sophisticated radar detection systems over those vast territories. Attacking Israel, however, is a different matter. The approaches are relatively narrow and they're extremely well defended. So why did Iran decide to use an attack method using aerial vehicles so slow that the Israelis had as much as 8 hours of advanced warning that the attack was coming? Well, from an engineering perspective, I think there are a couple of possibilities. One is that Iran simply lacks the numbers of ballistic missiles necessary to do that kind of saturation attack in a matter of minutes instead of hours. So they may have had some hope that a quantity of cheap drones would force Israelis to expend their anti-aircraft resources and leave them vulnerable to a follow-on attack. But there's another possibility. It's conceivable that the Iranians choose this attack method because they knew that it would be ineffective in the end. 8 hours of preparation is an eternity for a modern air defense system, and the amount of damage caused by the attack is incredibly low. But for domestic Iranian political consumption, it was a massive aerial assault on a nation they regard as a hated enemy. And it's likely that the Iranians felt that they had to do something in a big way in response to the Israeli attack on the Iranian consular building next to their embassy in Syria. So consider this possibility. Iranian leadership has to respond to what they regard as a provocation from Israel. But they know that the use of ballistic missiles will result in a likely counterattack within minutes or hours. But the Iranians felt that they had to do something. So they turned to a proven domestic technology that allowed them to launch a massive attack with the knowledge that almost none of the weapons will actually get through and cause significant damage, leaving the Israelis with the option of a limited or no reprisal because the attack was so ineffective. A crazy conspiracy theory? Well, it appears to be exactly what happened. In America, the development of effective ICBMs from the early 1960s, along with submarine-launched ballistic missiles, rendered nuclear crewed bombers like the B-52 effectively obsolete, something the U.S. Navy pointed out at the time. Yet they were preserved and still exist today as part of a doctrine called the Nuclear Triad. And a major argument for preservation of B-52s, B-1s, and B-2s is that they move slowly, giving leadership on both sides of a looming nuclear war a little time to negotiate a stand down. The technical reality of intercontinental ballistic missiles is that the counterattack must be launched while the incoming warheads are in flight in a matter of minutes. So the slow attack may be the off-ramp that prevents a larger war. Now, if that's Iran's game, it's a clever one because it satisfies their political objectives without causing mass casualties. Even small and relatively unsophisticated countries can develop a strategic attack capability by building or buying several thousand small drones today. It's like something out of a sci-fi movie, and it's happening right now. Now, in one respect, it's not good, but compared to ballistic missiles, it's better. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.